Perfect. So, well, thank you, first of all, for the invitation. I think I'm very excited. As you mentioned, I'm working for Eptikar, which is a Qatari company working in innovation and different parts of innovation. We work very close to the additive fabrication concepts, and especially with fab labs. So today we're going to talk about the fourth industrial revolution and the developing of new skills, but through fab labs, which is actually an amazing international network that allowed us actually to change the way we see the technology and how we can apply in different fields, let's say. But I want to start with this, which is actually some interesting data about what is happening in the few decades. And something interesting that I want to talk about is how also the market changed a lot. For example, in the 1900s, two-thirds of the population was working in agriculture and manufacturing. So we'd say like around 38-25% on each one. But now everything is changing and it's 1 to 10 of that. So does that mean that it's 50% of the population is unemployed, which actually is not the way? So why I'm putting this example is that now we're actually having a shift on how jobs and new opportunities have been created. But also now we're actually coming and we're getting new jobs, new opportunities, new companies, and so on. And an example of this is, for example, if we talk about the people who drive cars and trucks, they are actually, maybe they're going to lose their job in 5, 10 years, right? But now those jobs are going to be replaced for new industries and also concepts that we don't know, and we don't know it yet, okay? So I think right now we're living an amazing revolution. It's not more just about a revolution driven by technology. It's an extraordinary opportunity to help and support citizens, of course, people in the different positions, politics, local and central governments, and any type of people, regardless their gender, income, and of course, what is happening is that we're going to give us the advance of use emerging technologies to create and build an inclusive future, which is going to be more centered in how we can have, as a human beings, relationship with our context. And why is that important? Because, and why I'm talking about these topics, these new opportunities, these new jobs, these new things happening sounds amazing, but actually we need to be very careful because at the same time, there are so many questions about, okay, now we're living a revolution, which is an example of mobile connectivity, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, next generation of robots, 3D printings, advanced materials, and so on. So that means that now we're moving to something that is demanding new skills and abilities. And that's why it's very important to talk about the human capital and what it does mean, right? And how now everything which is related to innovation and the application of new technologies are actually having a huge influence on the skills required for production and for consumption as well. So it's interesting to understand a little bit more about how the Global Human Capital Index is based on, and which this we the human capital means that and is defined by the knowledge and skills that people possess to create value in the economic system. And it's interesting to see this because it's managed and it's analyzed by four topics, which is capacity, which is the level of formal education of younger and older generations as a result of the past education. Development, which is the formal education of the next generation of workforce. Deployment, which is the application of those skills among the adult population. And the know-how, which is the breadth and the depth of the skills and the specialized skills we have. And this is divided in five different groups, or let's say generations. So I want to see a little bit, I want to discuss a little bit how is the global human capital globally, which are the five top countries. But if we come to the region, we can see that in the Middle East, Israel is having a good performance, UAE as well. Bahrain is only the third position. And I want to talk about Qatar because I'm based in Doha. So it's interesting to see how things are happening here. So we can see that, for example, the position is 50-55. We have an amazing capacity level, which is 94, which means, okay, we have a very good investment on education. But if you see that deployment is terrible, it's actually one of the worst ones. And that means that those application and that accumulation of a skill is not in all the adult population. So we're doing an amazing job on infrastructure, but a terrible way how to organize and how to distribute this knowledge and this know-how. So, and I really want to talk about this. I think mostly everyone knows about what is this concept and how this is actually having an important impact on what we need to do and what we need to understand about the skills. But the most important thing is like, okay, right now we're talking about the technology that is changing so fast that today the skills that we need maybe are going to change in 5 months, 5 years, we don't know. But the lifelong learning concept is something that we must apply every day and that we need to understand how to apply it. And at the same time, we need to understand how our different kind of skills and how those skills can actually shape the way we're doing and working. We have the soft skills, which is more about how we as individuals are working with different people, how we can actually be critical thinkers, how we can solve problems, and so on. But also, there are so many new trending topics for technology that we need to be aware. And Fab Labs are an amazing space actually to share and to do this kind of interaction. For the people who doesn't know about Fab Labs, is fabrication laboratories where you have the opportunity to work on a very, very open and a very amazing community that share knowledge and also that use, of course, digital fabrication to produce things. And what is this important for entrepreneurs is because right now for an entrepreneur to test, to validate, and to understand if their product, their idea is something that can be a good product in the market, you can actually prototype it, you can actually fail fast, you can validate, and you can use these local manufacturing facilities to improve your process. So instead of going to China for the final product and then go to the market and maybe fail, you can actually go, you can prototype, do it fast, and you can actually also learn at the same time. So as an entrepreneur, and for all the startups and companies, you can see that there's the different stages where we go through it, right? And now in each one, we can see where the Fab Lab is given an amazing opportunity to validate this, to actually to create more skills, but especially how to combine skills with different people. So in the validation, you have the opportunity to prototype. You can come with your idea and you can analyze it and you can validate it fast. And this is not just for a startup, also a company who has actually already a product but wants to innovate, so can redefine the whole production, can redefine through prototyping, through MVPs, and actually have a variation on the way they're producing things. So, but also it's interesting to know and important to know that digital fabrication and Fab Labs had also like an limitation, and it's based on it's an amazing space to validate, to test your idea, to prove if it's possible to take it to the market. But it's important to know that after that process is we become something which has to be connected to a bigger network, because you're gonna mass produce, you need to think about packaging and so on. So it's important to know where are all the different agents on the process to develop an idea. And what is the final outcome of this? It's actually to become a prosumer. So if we analyze our way of living, if we analyze the concept of circular economy as well, we can see that right now there's so many opportunities for us to be a producer and a consumer. So instead of me just driving my feelings of what should I consume through what the market is telling me, I can take decisions and I can fabricate it, and Fab Labs can give me that opportunity. And if we use that for entrepreneurships and for the entrepreneurship process, that will be amazing. So I think I tried to summarize everything in a very quick way. And this is actually the topic I want to discuss it today, about how Fab Labs can actually work, how Fab Labs are supporting entrepreneurs, and how actually this can be an amazing way to validate ideas and to prototype it fast, to take actions for any kind of product we want to develop.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Robert. Thank you for joining us and for talking about this digital revolution, which is a term we can use for the fourth industrial revolution.